Hi, this is Toby from Cuttle. In this tutorial, we'll be making this dodecahedron candle holder. And in this part one, we'll be making this pentagon shape with glue tabs on it. So this is what the Cuttle editor looks like. And over here, we have the built-in components, and these shapes we can create by dragging them onto the canvas. So I'm going to drag a polygon onto the canvas. And once it's on the canvas, you can deselect by clicking the background or select. You can move things around by dragging them. There are these resize handles and rotate handles. So if you're on the handle, it's resize. So I'm going to make this polygon bigger. And if I just drag this, then then you can resize it to any size. And if I hold shift, then it will resize, preserving the original aspect ratio. So I'll do that and make it about that big. There's some dimensions over here so you can see how big the shape is in inches, which is how my project is configured right now. When you drag things, you can choose to drag from certain given snap points. And so I'm going to drag from the origin and put that in the center of my canvas, the canvas origin. So now I have a pentagon that's centered on the canvas. The polygon also has a sides property. And this I can change either by dragging on the number. So I can drag it and change the number like that. Or I can type in a number by hitting it on my keyboard. So I want a pentagon, so I'll keep it at 5. So that's going to be my pentagon. And now I want to create the flaps, the glue flaps around the edges of the pentagon. So I'm going to drag in a rectangle. And now I'm going to take advantage of the snapping that I just showed you. So if you drag from the top left corner of this rectangle, I can position it so that it's exactly at the this point on the pentagon. And this kind of snapping is called geometry snapping, and it's on by default, but you can disable it or enable it. It's enabled if it's blue. And when I have geometry snapping on, it allows me to pick a point that I want to snap from, so for example, a corner, and then pick a point that I want to snap to by dragging it there, and then it will automatically snap in that way. So I can snap that here. And then similarly, if I want to make this rectangle be as wide as this pentagon, I can drag from here and then snap to that corner. And then it will be exactly sized. And then I'm also going to make it a little bit narrower. And that'll be the folding tab on the pentagon. Next, what I want to do is I want to take this rectangle and replicate it around the pentagon so that it's on each side. And a useful thing that I have is the rotational repeat modifier. So this modify menu has all sorts of modifiers that you can use that change your shape, or in the case of the repeat modifiers, it replicates your shape. So if I choose rotational repeat, then I have a bunch of copies of the shape. The rotational repeat properties are down here. If I want to just focus on these, I can also click on this, we call this the badge, the rotational repeat badge that's on the rectangle, and then it will show me the properties for the rotational repeat. And so I probably want to change the number of repetitions. So I can drag on this and change how many repetitions there are. In this case, I want 5 so that it perfectly goes around the pentagon. And we can also change the center of rotation. By default, it's at 0, 0, which is the center of my canvas. So I can change that either in the inspector here, or I can drag this center. And so this is the center that it's replicating my original rectangle around. But I want to just keep it in the center. And in general, it's handy to build symmetric shapes around the canvas origin, just as sort of a way to organize all your shapes. So now I have these rectangles, and I have this pentagon, and now I want to fuse all these into a single shape. And I can do that by selecting all of the shapes, and I can do that by creating one of these box selects. So you just start dragging on the canvas, and then anything within the rectangle is selected. So I've selected both the pentagon and the rectangle, and you can see that those are selected here in the outline panel. And next, I'm going to apply a Boolean union to those. And so then you can't see it because it's selected now, but if I deselect, then you can see that it took all those shapes and Boolean unioned them together. And so you can also see it in the outline. So I had the pentagon and the rectangle, and then when I did the Boolean union, it automatically created a group around those two shapes and applied the Boolean union modifier. All right, so now I have, this is the shape that I'm going to cut out, but I'm also would like to put score lines for where the tabs are going to fold, which I can do with my Cricut. But I need to make the score lines in a different color so I can tell the Cricut to score rather than cut those lines. And so what I'd like to do is take this polygon. So I'm going to select it in the outline by just clicking in the outline. So now I have this polygon, and I'm going to copy it. You can go to Edit Copy or hit Command C. So I've copied it. And now something to notice is that we're within a group context now. And you can tell because there's this spotlight. And that means that I can select the things within the group. Rather than if I were outside of this context, which I can do by double-clicking on the background, now I'm outside the group context, and so I can only select the group. I don't select the things within the group. If I want to select within the group, I can either use the outline, or I can double-click on the group, and now I'm able to select the shapes within the group. So I'm going to double click to be outside that context, and I'm going to paste my polygon. So now I have another copy of that polygon, and I want to give it a different color. So I'm going to, by default, everything is just has no fill and has a hairline, what's called a hairline black stroke by default, but I can change that by checking the stroke in the inspector, and then I can change the color. So I'll just put it as red. You can pick any color you like. And now it appears red. Something else to notice about the stroke panel is by default this hairline is checked, but if I uncheck it, then I'm able to change the width of the the stroke along with things like, is it a centered stroke or is it inner or outer? But since I'm just using this as a score line, I'm going to keep it hairline, so it'll always be sort of the as thin as possible. And you can actually change what the hairline stroke width is in this project tab. I was over here, which is normally where I am, but then in the project tab, we can change, for example, the units for the project. I'll keep it in inches. You can change the hairline stroke. For example, certain laser cutters insist that you make your cut lines 0.001 inches or whatever they need to be. And you can also rename your project here, which maybe I'll do. And I'll say dodecahedron T light holder. All right. So that's part one. And in part two, we'll put a design on this and cut it out. Thanks for watching.